TV hour level, I'll just give you a brief description real quick, because I'm honored that so many people raised their hand. With my organization, we're about to be on the 3-year anniversary, and we have over 300 survivors from 13 different countries. We have survivors sharing, or caregivers sharing their story of hope. This is about people worldwide, and with my organization, we are building a positive forum that is spread of hope, love, inspiration, and education, not only to those who have sustained a brain injury of any size, any way, but also most importantly, we're ending the silence for the next generation. Because none of the survivors want individuals to go through what we went through, but it's sad how it occurs more than any form of cancer, is the highest death rate, and it is the least talked about. I mean, you had in 2011 when I sustained mine, I learned about the heart, which I'm sure all of us did, unfortunately. But we are a life that will change. And during that year, the average in America alone was 1.7 million every 20 to 25 seconds. And as you know the numbers right now, every 10 seconds you have 2.5 to 3 million. That's just in America alone. In the entire world, thanks to the brain injury, the International Brain Injury Study, every 2 seconds, 60 million per year. Every 2 seconds, 60 million. And how many people can say, oh, we see that report, or we hear about brain injuries all the time on the news? We don't. So we have to change not only with us attending here, but this needs to be more active. And I'd love for you guys to join my organization, not only to inspire me, but inspire the whole world and fill it with hope and love. And that's a perfect ending, because that is success. We all need success. We all need a push. Some of us survivors, let's be honest, and I'm not saying this in a bad way, we do need more of us, a shove. And it's not to shove them down, because we have the ability to lift people up, because with guidance, love, inspiration, and hope, we are rebuilding the world and making sure that their neurons are actually wired to be, think, do, and have success. Because we are what we think. I can't get over that enough. People think, oh, you love your brain. Yes, and that's the most important thing. We do need to love our brain. We need to take care of it. We need to give it the time it needs. We need to take nutrients. It's amazing, you know, the amount of outreach that has been obtained to help with medication. You don't go see a doctor. You can buy that store for brain stuff. I mean, fish oil, having coconut oil, creatine is good for your brain. Coffee, I mean, there's so many people chewing gum, whistling. How many of you love to whistle? Did you know that whistling? My dad loves to whistle, so I know he does. But when you whistle, that is actually creating a memorization band in your neuron. So that's why you can sing the same, whistle the same song, I'm sorry. It's not saying that you love that song. It's like, no, my brain memorizes it. So you do a different tune. And even when you listen to music when you go to sleep, I'm trying to learn a new language. I'd like to introduce my wife, Elena Durham, right here. This is one of my big motivational supporters. So I'm excited about it. Say the best way to learn a new language is not only to have motivation and teamwork, let's be honest, but also listening to that when you go to sleep with headphones, because when your brain is shutting down, for some of us brain injuries, that doesn't happen, our brain doesn't shut down, but you have the ability to store new information that leads to success. Because once you think about success, you will be, do, and most importantly, act. Now, I'd like to give also some other important information as you see on the board about goal setting. We need to each set a goal. It may be daily or weekly. Maybe just one. Because with memorization, when you write stuff down, you have the ability to not only process the information, but then you won't want to do it moving forward. Like, okay, it's on my list or I forgot. How many here have a goal list? How many here, when you go to the store, will have a list? Am I the only one? Thank you. So when you do that, you need to make sure you get yourself off. That's easy. But if you do that a continuous amount of times, your goals will not only get checked off, but you're actually reboosting your brain to have more cognitive improvement, and goals become achievements. So we always have goals. Everyone doesn't like, especially no matter what it is, get stuff from the store. I want to be able to do this. I mean, there's a wide list. We don't have enough time to list and state these out loud. But when you do this, not only you will be more successful, but then you have this wide list of achievements, and that's going to be natural. Because when you take the little steps to get somewhere, you think, okay, I need to take big steps. But we all need to realize that the little steps really are the big steps. No matter what your tradition is, no matter what you're doing, like, okay, I got to get there faster. Because if you rush too hard, the steps are going to break through, and then you're going to start right back to square one. And it's not saying that you did something wrong. No, it's saying you just didn't do something properly. Because there's a certain way to do everything in life. You have to take steps, you have to move forward, you have to do it properly to obtain not only the information you need, but most important, be able to store it within your computer system so that way you can be more improving and use it successfully. Now, as you know, TBI stands for traumatic brain injury, and there's such a wide spread. And there's TBI, ABI, concussion is a TBI, CTE, there's so many brain injuries. I call it, and I want you survivors to raise your hand, or the family members with your survivors, to understand that a TBI really is this cubicle injury. The reason it is because not only is a life-changing event, but the old you needed. Not because, I don't want you saying that, oh yeah, I love you. We all need to love ourselves, that's a number of things, but the old us ended not because it was something bad we did or wasn't good enough, no. You need to change your perspective and look at the positive things, which are found in everything. Because when you realize, oh, it's a new you, we still have the same thing. We still have the same information. But with the new you, you can live new dreams, you can have new goals, new achievements, and new mindset. Because once you are done with the old, you have fresh new one that's about to start, and you'll be amazingly surprised within a short, medium, and long time frame what's going to take place. Because anything is possible when you put your mind to it. Some other helpful information I would love to share with you guys that helped change my lifestyle to be more positive and love the life of it is not only to understand that life is about completing, not competing, because we're all one of a kind. There will never be a sequel. Unless you get a brain injury, there'll be a new form. Let's be honest. Now, another key term is, like I said, we need to love our brain. That is the only organ in our body that cannot be replaced unless there's an app made, an iPhone, you never know. But we need to make sure to give it the attention it needs, take care of. Like Dr. Wiggs was saying about sleep, you know, that's very important. I have to take melatonin. But you need to care, love, and act with your brain. Use it, don't abuse it. Another key term is to always remind yourself how blessed you are. Not only to be yourself, but to have the life to live and continue to move forward, because a lot of people, either those we know or those we will never know, would do anything to have what we have and be who we are. It doesn't matter what difficulty you're battling through. So understand, and I can't state it enough, not only are you too blessed to be stressed, but you need to love the life you live because you're granted with it. Instead of thinking, oh, I can't do this, or I want to be someone else, or I'm jealous of what they have. That's great. That's not yours. We all have such an amazing purpose here. And when you sustain your brain injury for all you inspirational survivors that help you, you're inspiring others just because you're still here. You have the inspiration of still being here, which a lot of survivors do not get the blessing that other families don't get. The opportunity to see their family member be how you are, even if it's within a short or long period of time. So, I can't remind you enough how blessed you are. I want to thank you guys for this opportunity. Are there any questions that anyone has so far about my organization? Yes, ma'am.
Are you going to have a printout of this information?
Yes, ma'am. I do have some handouts, and I will have some printouts also as well. Yes, ma'am.
Right, but I can't see
them. Oh, I'm sorry. Yes, ma'am. Yes, sir.
Where's your website?
My website is www.tbionelove.org. Not only you'll find inspiration, here I'll put the logo for you, sir. Not only you'll find inspirational guidance from other survivors, my story is on there as well. You can hear more in depth about that, about my trip to heaven with my absent loved ones when I was up, when returning was not an option. So you can hear not only and relate to yourself how powerful positivity really is. But wow, I'm not the one going through something like this. Now, as you know, no brain injury is exact. Just because it's the same area of the brain doesn't mean it's going to be the same result.
I heard you interview someone yesterday. I didn't know you were going to be here first.
Hey, you know what? I got offered a blessing, and I want to thank you all for such an unbelievable opportunity. I hope to not only work more with you, be more involved. I want to eat each and every one of you. Hear about your survival, or if you want to survive. You know, hear about your life, because you think that this room is shining because these lights here? No, it's being lit from the floor up, because that's all of you. be able not only to continue to believe in myself, but to see everyone's going through something. By you showing your hand, you have the willingness to let people know. So we're not alone, because that's something that survivors go through. We need to create a team. You guys are the team. Because team has no I in it. That's why it stands for together, everyone achieves. Are there any other questions? Yes, ma'am.
James, I'm just curious, I know you said you went before the university.
Yes, ma'am.
Was that something that you planned to do before your brain injury, to become a professional speaker, or did your brain injury change that?
Oh, my brain injury changed that. Great question. And before, like I stated, I always had a learning disability. Not only getting a 2.0, but keeping one was extremely hard. So when I moved to San Antonio, I was trying to do both community college and working in apartment industry. So I said, you know what, I'm just going to work. School's not my thing. Growing up, I had a learning disability. But because my head got hit hard enough, shaken, not stirred, don't go get that. That's what happened. I was able to relearn it. I don't have a learning disability anymore. So I was able, not only when I tried to go back to school, after I got done with CNS, Center for Neuro Skills in Irving, Texas, we've always had a family vacation on Panama City Beach, Florida. I went out there, being blind in my left eye, I had to learn how to drive again. I don't think driving downtown Dallas, all the highway construction is good for a blind person, especially with a brain injury, let's be honest. Be like a monitor car. So I went to the Panama City Beach, Florida, just to finally be away from doctors and nurses. And I told my family, I said, you know what? This is a very quiet area, it's one road. I think I should try to go to school here. And less distraction, I don't have a lot of friends. So it's like, oh, you don't need to do the other thing. You know, I want to learn about brain injury or what you're doing. I just want to coach you. So I went there, and it was amazing. There was no learning disability. I still, you know, I assumed that how always was I need to go to the testing center, not guidance. One of my disabilities is if someone's saying a certain word, it can be a common word that I've heard about or used in a sentence multiple times. I'll ask them, what do you mean by that? So that way when I respond, it's not that I was not paying attention, like, oh, brain injury, yeah, yours out there. No, I'm on the same page. After that, I was able to get my A, and I applied to Forte. That's where my parents went to school, so it was a dream always. But because of my learning disability growing up, I was like, okay, college is not my thing. There's no way. I'll cheer for them all the time. Yeah, go Noles. But I'm never going to go there. And I got in, I went to apply with my mom, and they said, have you ever a class called public communication? Have you ever thought about that? I said, no, you know, I've been doing some public speaking. I speak to the nursing schools and other hospitals about brain injury. I tell my story, not only about, you know, the impact that life changing my trip to heaven. And then my mom explains, you know, the caregiver aspect, what the family went through, when I'm like, home, I don't know the information with numbers, procedures. I just know I've got some scars and some bumps and some plugs. That's all I know. And unfortunately, it was all meant to happen as a continuous flow of God, because I was supposed to go to Florida. I was supposed to get in that accident. It was a purpose. Because of that accident, now I'm moving to Florida, which I always wanted to live. It's always a dream, going back and forth, vacation home. But I went there to be more successful. I was able to finally get an AA. I got into my lifestyle dream where my parents got me the prepaid tuition from being born in Tallahassee, Florida. So I could make my grandparents proud. And one of the ones who I saw in heaven was the father who caught me. That's the one that prayed for the prepaid. So I could give him a big thank you. And amazingly, because there are no coincidences, only God incidences, I met my wife. And that's where we met. We took communication, but she was getting her second bachelor's. I was just getting my first. So, yeah, a little bit more. But yeah, that's why I want to introduce you. Not only it motivated me during Florida State, my wife did, but still daily, you know, support. It's amazing when you have that bond, which is, in today's world, is very rare. To find love, it's, you find it's always about judgment. They're going to say something, and a lot of people are afraid to open to meet other people, whether it's communication, because. And I learned this in class. Our body speaks a lot louder than our mouth. And you would never think that, but it does. So, are there any other questions? Not at all?
James, tell us about your radio show, who your guest is going to be this month.
Oh, okay. Thank you. Just in case you wanted to know, it's my dad. I do a blog talk radio with Brain Injury Network. I do it, I've been here for a year now, and it's really grabbed a lot of attention. I do it on the 1st, 3rd, and 5th Monday of every month from 9 to 11 p.m. I do it online. You can see the link on my website. I've had amazing guests. That's how I met Dr. Moyes. They found me. I love social media when people contact you, interested in not only your work, but they can see what you're doing that you can relate. We have coming up on this Monday, two different survivors on the home page. You'll see we have one from Alaska who's with the head board of a brain injury center that does Alaska and Hawaii. We've had amazing doctors from Canada. We've had Dr. Molly. We've had different athletes. We had a professional surfer, Harley Rose, who was on the USA surfing team, who sustained her brain injury from actually riding a surf wave and going face first into a sand pile and into the water. So it's amazing not only how common brain injuries really are, but how active they are and how many people want to do what we're doing. Give it the attention that's needed to not only end the silence, but give the next generation a brighter future, because we're all the example, not only for the studies, but for the brain injury survivors. We are what people need to see. And if they don't want to see it, they need to hear about it. It's the most powerful education we can give anyone. So I'd love to have you guys not only check out my organization for more encouragement, education, but also view my radio show. I'd love to have you guys on. Is from 9 to 11. Some people will talk from as little or as long as you want. Sometimes we have one guest. Sometimes we'll have two. If we have two, it'll be from like 9 to 10, then 10 to 11. But I'd love to have you guys on, not only to give your impact on the studies that you're obtaining, but your personal experience with brain injury, whether it's for patients or the survivor that you are. Any other questions? Well, thank you guys from the bottom of my heart. The opportunity not only to spread awareness and introduce myself, but show how powerful a positive mind really is, support, and most importantly, a bond. Thank you guys. I was praying for you all. Thank you.